Dear students, welcome to today's discussion, experimental research design. Let us begin with the meaning of a research design. So a research design is the roadmap or prior plan of any research study that has to include these following 4 points: the research method or approach. It may be descriptive, it may be experimental, the sampling design or the techniques of selecting the samples for the study, and the research tools or device with the help of which the investigator is going to collect his required data, and also the mode of analysis, that means treatment or mode of treating the collected data. It may be qualitative, it may be quantitative. Let us see how these 4 components are incorporated in an experimental research design. Let us begin with this definition given by William Best. He said that experimental design is the blueprint of the procedures that enables the researcher to test hypotheses by reaching valid conclusions about relationships between independent and dependent variables. All these aspects, the experimental research is there to test hypotheses. Valid conclusions are drawn. Relationship is established between independent and dependent variables. All these aspects actually depicts the characteristics or nature of experimental research. Let us see the characteristics of educational experiment. So an experiment is a query, the answer of which is consciously, systematically sought. If this is done under carefully controlled conditions, what will happen? Actually, experimental research is very scientific, very rigorous. But what I want to simply say, just to understand the spirit of experimental research, what I want to say that our life itself is the laboratory of experiment. Off and on, we conduct experiments on different aspects of our life. It may be our dress sense, it may be our food habit, it may be our lifestyle, from these to medical science, educational technology or technology, all these fields are filled with experimental, different types of experiment. Just for sake of understanding, I just want to mention one simple example. Suppose I assume or hypothesize that by eating mint leaves, that means the pudina, will enhance the taste of my cup of tea. Here, the pudina or mint is the independent variable and the dependent variable is the cup of tea. Other things remain controlled or same. After adding the tea, I compare the taste of tea with my previous one and the added one, and then compare and observe and deduce the conclusion that adding pudina can enhance the taste of tea. This is simply the spirit of experimental research. But to be truly experimental, it must adhere to some scientific conditions or rules. So experimental research is that kind of research which is very specific, the result of which is too true, too authentic, too valid, as it has to fulfill some specific condition or basic assumptions, and that's why it is called scientific research design. Another characteristics of experimental research is that it is a means of verifying hypothesis, as in the definition saying. A hypothesis, as you know, a hypothesis is a tentative solution of problems. It is an assumption that is based on different rational thinking, which is the product of rational thinking, or which is based on our previous experience, etc. Through experimental research or in experimental research, these hypotheses are tested. Here, hypothesis may be accepted or it may be rejected after observation. Another characteristics of experimental research is that Here, variables can be manipulated. Sometimes questions may arise. Where or in which research approach variables can be manipulated? In experimental research approach. Sometimes questions may also arise. Which type of variables are manipulated in experimental research? This is independent variables. Independent variables are those variables, as the name says, those can be manipulated or introduced by the experimenter that has their capacity to influence other factors. So these independent variables are manipulated. Suppose some new educational technique, suppose program learning, suppose activity based learning, all these are independent variables that can be manipulated by the experimenter to see the dependent variable, the performance or the academic achievements, etc. So in experimental researches, these independent variables are manipulated to see its effect in dependent variable, and with the help of this, the causal relationship, that means cause-effect relationship between two factors, is established or studied. But simply observing is not there, or comparison is there. It must be controlled observation. Control means along with independent, to study the independent relationship between independent and dependent variables, all other variables, the extraneous variables that may have also the capacity to influence the study, must be controlled by the investigator to be truly experimental. So there must not be any influence of other factors, and for that observation need to be too systematic, too rigorous, too scientific, and all other factors must be controlled and observation must be controlled. And on the basis of this, after observation, comparison is made and the result is deduced. Suppose Pavlov has conducted the experiment and giving us the conclusion that we can learn through conditioning, and after, with the help of these findings, further researches is going on by Skinner or the program learning. All these are based on this deduction that we can learn by conditioning. So the findings that we have with the help of experimental research can be applied in other aspects too. Basically, this research approach is applied in physical science, but though in educational research we deal with behavioral aspects, with some specifications we also apply this research approach in educational research. Another aspect or characteristics of this research, the experimental research adopt quantitative mode of data analysis. So sometimes questions may be there, in which types of research approach quantitative analysis is made. Particularly, though quantitative approach may be there in descriptive research, but particularly in experimental research, the data are analyzed quantitatively. So these are the basic characteristics of experimental research. Let us try to understand this diagram. With the help of this diagram, this is actually a classic example of health sector. Suppose what I mean, these are the COVID-19 patients, and they are randomly selected and categorized into two groups, the control group and the treatment group. Treatment group is that group upon which the independent variables will be manipulated, and here in the control group no such kind of treatment will be given. Suppose the hydroxychloroquine, that is given for treatment of COVID, and still it is undergoing through experiment. Suppose we are giving this treatment group the independent variable hydroxychloroquine and see the result in their health status. Their health status is the dependent variable. The control group is not given that independent variable, that means hydroxychloroquine is not given to this control group, rather placebo is given. Suppose the suppose giving some sugar pill, and then follow up is made of both the groups. If it is observed that the group treatment group has better health position and the control group has the less health status, then after comparing the results of these both health status, we may deduce the conclusion. Accept the hypothesis, if this treatment group done better in health status, we may accept the hypothesis that hydroxychloroquine is effective in treating COVID-19 patients. On the other hand, if there is no significant difference in both the result of the both the result of the health status, in that case we may reject the hypothesis that hydroxychloroquine is not that much effective in treating COVID-19 patients. This is basically the idea of experimental research, where we hypothesize there is independent variable the which is given to the treatment variable, treatment group. So mind that dear students, that sometimes questions may come, which variable is manipulated by the experimenter? The independent variable is always manipulated, dependent variable is always observed. The effect of the independent variable on the dependent variable is observed. Let us see with the help of an example of educational field, from educational field. Suppose we hypothesize that activity-based learning of mathematics may enhance students' understanding better. In this design, these are not persons now, they are students. They are selected randomly. Randomly means they have equal opportunity of selecting, and categorized randomly to the treatment group and the control group. So here the independent variable is the activity-based learning of mathematics. This independent variable is introduced here in the treatment group, and the control group is taught by the traditional chalk and talk or lecture method. And after that, the follow-up is made, that means the scholastic assessment test on mathematics is taken, and the result is compared and observed. If the result of the treatment group is better than the control group, if the result of the treatment group, that means those who are treated or with the independent variables, means those who are taught by the activity-based method, is performance is good or better than the control group, then the hypothesis will be accepted that activity-based learning is better in understanding of mathematics. So the control group's results also or it may be vice versa. If there is no significant difference, then the hypothesis will be rejected. So this is the spirit of an experimental research approach. So where the independent variable's effect is observed on the dependent variable, keeping all other things constant or controlled. So dear students, I hope you have an understanding of this experimental research approach. In our next class, we shall discuss about some basic assumptions on the when we can turn an experiment a truly experimental. As I have said, actually we all adopt such types of approach in our day-to-day life. But to be truly experimental, we must have to fulfill some conditions. Then only it will turn to experimental. So I hope to discuss all those conditions in the next class. Until then, thank you and goodbye.